Not a good week for President Obama. Roll the headlines.
Overshadowed by a prostitution scandal involving members of the Secret Service.
Yet another apology for yet another instance of U.S. troops behaving badly in Afghanistan.
Those government officials who attended that conference in Las Vegas and spent taxpayer money on mind readers and clowns.
The agency that protects him, under fire. The agency representing the country on the battlefield, under fire. The agency that oversees government agencies, under fire. The Secret Service, the GSA, the Armed Forces. While the president doesn't directly run these organizations, he is the president. And as much as Democrats don't want to hear it, people like Sarah Palin have a point.
These departments, the buck stops with the president, and he's really got to start cracking down and seeing some heads roll. You know, he's got to get rid of these people at the head of these agencies.
Mm-hmm. At the head of these agencies, he's also the head of the economy. He's in charge of it. Yet almost 4 years later, his entire administration is running around still blaming a bad economy on George W. Bush.
Take a look at what happened in Ohio between 2000 and 2008. Instead of faster job growth, we had the slowest job growth in half a century.
The president inherited, again, as you know, the worst financial crisis since the Great Depression.
The worst crisis since the Great Depression when he came into office.
You know, this was a financial crisis caused by a shock larger than what caused the Great Depression.
And too many people have been stripped of their dignity as a consequence of this god-awful recession we've inherited.
It is true that they inherited the worst economy since the Great Depression. The research shows it. It does. It shows it. But it's the same talking points you ran on last time. And again, you know, maybe the GSA, the Secret Service, and the bad soldiers aren't all your fault. Even conservative stalwart George Will agrees.
It is unfair to blame Barack Obama for the GSA or any of these things because although people think he controls the executive branch, no one controls the executive branch. That's part of the problem with big government.
So everyone understands it's an election year and you need something to hang your hat on. You need something to hang your hat on, but no one likes a broken record. And at some point, you're going to have to take responsibility for the things that happen on your watch, regardless of what went down or up before you took office, and stop pointing fingers backwards. That's tonight's No Talking Points.